Do you want to capture your ideas quickly and easily and then be able to visualize them in a way that makes sense to you? Well, in this video, I'm showing you five different ways to organize all of your ideas right here within Walling. One of the reasons why I keep coming back to Walling is just how easy it is to capture and input information. In this example, I'm looking at redesigning a website homepage, and the very first section which I've created is ideas. Now, in this example, I already have a couple of bricks where I've started to input many of my ideas. But if I want to add more, all I have to do is double click anywhere on the screen. And maybe I'm going to suggest that we get rid of the slideshow on the homepage. I can give that as a title here. And then if I want to add some further details, this is slowing down the load time of our home screen. Something along those lines there. Now, of course, I can add a lot more information here as well, including the ability to tag this, because this would really be more of an SEO issue in this case. And if I really want this one to stand out, I can also come over here and maybe give it a distinctive color. In addition to text, we can also make images stand out as we're collecting our ideas. So, for example, take a look at more 3D graphics. Maybe that's something else that I'd like us to include. So in this case, all I'm gonna do is paste an image that I found off of another website, and it's nice and clear. It doesn't just add it as a simple attachment, so I need to go and open it later. If I want to see the image in its full screen, I can do so here, but it's just that much more stimulating. It's gonna be that much more easier for myself and members of my team to take a look. Again, I'm gonna add a quick tag here because that would fall under the design category. But we can also add more complex elements as well. Here you can see I've added a note about adding responsive images. And if I come down here to the Insert tab, you can see the wide range of different things in which we can add, including a code block. So in this case, what I'm going to do is paste a piece of code, which I grabbed just earlier, and now I have it right here as a part of my ideas. So no longer do I have to reference something to someone else. Now they can come in here, grab this piece of code, and actually add it directly to the project or the web page that we're working on. And maybe just for further clarity, if I want these code snippets to stand out even more, I'm going to give each of these bricks just a different shade, or a similar shade, I should say, so that they stand out and we can see that they're grouped together. But if we want to go one step further and be able to filter or save some specific views, we can do that here as well. And that's where the many different views and filters and the ability to pin those filters becomes so important. In this case, maybe I want to add this all view to the top of my section. Therefore, I can just quickly click on this and see everything rather than having to disengage or clear a filter. But let's add a few more. I'm going to add one here called SEO. I'm going to create that view here. And then what I'm going to do is apply a filter to it. So if I apply this filter here, I only want to see the tags that have SEO applied. I'm going to say filter, that filter is on. And what I can also do is now pin this to the top as well. So if I need to toggle between all of my ideas and see everything within this section, or if I just want to narrow it down to SEO, I can do that here quickly and easily, and now just focus on the things that I want. Now, the second way in which we can quickly and easily organize our ideas is by using a Kanban method. I'm going to add a new section down here called copywriting. So this is where we're going to add some additional ideas here. But instead of having it visual, I'm going to select a Kanban option here as well. So for example, maybe I'm going to add a section called taglines. I'm going to add another one here called descriptions. And then maybe a last one, which is going to be call to actions. I think it's important for us to remember that the Kanban style of viewing your information doesn't have to mean to do, doing, and done, or moving things together. Maybe you would prefer a more column style or grouping things together as in this manner. Let me go ahead and add a few examples. Now you can see that I've grouped my ideas under these respective column headings, so it's easy to see and easy to work with. And if I want to, of course, I can drag and rearrange that content as well. And don't forget, you're not limited to just adding colors to the bricks themselves, but you can add them to the headers as well. So in this case, maybe I want descriptions to stand out a bit more because that's where we're lacking the most. I can give that an accent color here as well. And regardless as to how you structure or lay out your ideas, walling makes it so easy for us to include images or other files. Let's say in this note here under descriptions, there's a PowerPoint, which is directly related to this. All I need to do is drag and copy it, and now I've got that file directly embedded here. Easy access for myself and my colleagues when we're discussing this particular idea. Now, a third way of organizing your information within walling is by creating a section for one specific topic. Sometimes we can be tempted to create bricks which have a large number of bullet points, but sometimes if they're too lengthy or too long, things can get lost. So in this case, I want to discuss about our target audience here. So I'm going to create a new section called Target Audience. And instead of creating one brick, what I'm going to do is create several bricks that have key headings or key statistics. So maybe my first brick will be called Key Demographics. That's where we want to focus on those specific numbers and specific data about our clients. I'm just going to copy and paste the key information for this brick, and then I can add something next to it, maybe something like preferred platforms. What are our clients actually using on a regular basis? So in this case, I can just list things such as maybe Facebook and YouTube. And if I have relevant information to go along with that, I can do that as well. Maybe LinkedIn is another place that we want to focus on. And lastly, maybe preferred devices. Where are people finding us? And should we be more focused on that when we're creating our new website? And maybe we understand that 82% of our clients are finding us on mobile devices. So things like this we can organize in a bit more of a linear fashion, key pieces of information that stands out without having to group all of this within a single brick. Also keep in mind, if you need to make edits or changes, you can customize each of these sections. Here you can see under my target audience, I've got three different columns, but if I need more, I can come in here and adjust that to my needs. Now I can add another key metric or another key area of my target audience, and again, keep things nice and slim, nice and compact before I add my next section. And for that, we're going to look at our fourth way of organizing our information. And for this, I'm going to call this section Files and Assets. How often have you been looking for a particular file, a particular image, or something else that is relevant to the project that you're working on or the thing that you're brainstorming with? And sometimes it can be difficult to find it within the brick or the area which you've created. That's where creating a files or reference section can be so helpful. Now, rather than going to find things one at a time, again, walling makes it super easy to bulk import files and assets. Here on the right-hand side, I have a collection of files that I would like to add to this section. But just before I do, I'm actually going to change the section view from visual to list, and I'll show you why. I'm going to select all of these files and simply just drag them into my list here under files and assets. And what it's going to do is bring all of those files in here, easy for me to see and access. Now, you could still change the view here if you wanted to, but I find that the list view is perhaps the most functional. Now, because it's a list, it's going to show some checkboxes and due dates and who it's assigned to. Don't worry, we can make some simple adjustments. At the top of every section, we have the opportunity to customize that section. So, for example, I can remove the mark complete, I can remove the due date and the assigned in this case. So maybe I want to leave the tags because I'm going to be adding some tags later. Whatever you are creating or whatever section you are building out, you have so many different customizable options available to you. And just like with other bricks within walling, we can make our files stand out as well. Maybe I want this particular PDF to stand out. I'm going to give it a red shade. And this spreadsheet over here, I'm going to give it a slightly green shade just so people understand that it's a spreadsheet. And maybe it's something that we use more often than the other files in this section. Now, the fifth way in which we can organize our ideas is by creating an inspiration section. And this is especially helpful if you're wanting to add a number of graphics, screenshots, or maybe just links to other web pages or other resources. Here, I've titled this section Inspirations, and I've got a number of images already on my desktop. I'm just going to click and drag, drop them here into Inspirations, and now I have them automatically added. So I can come back in here and take a look at maybe some of the color schemes or some of the other things that we want to consider. But walling also makes it super easy. If I want to grab this image, it's just click, bring it up to my walling tab and drop, and immediately I have that image available to me as well. So again, a great visual way of grabbing those graphics and keeping them nice and clean in their own section. Now, I'd love to hear from you next. What questions do you have about organizing ideas right here within walling? Be sure to let me know in the comments down below. And if you're already a Notion or Trello user, you may want to watch this video to see why walling may be a better solution for you. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.